Aloha. This special events program is brought to you by the Law Office of Attorney Daphne Barbie and the Office of Attorney Andre Wooten. We hope you enjoy it. Mahalo.
Attack, Ahmad. Come on, Karban. Yes, Karban. Good picture. I hold Solbach. Come in. Hooray, hooray. Hi. Roger, come here, Adlin Bach.
I know you don't know what life is really worth.
I hold, I take the California hills, go ahead, come.
So now you see the light.
Pablon, Bahar. Yes, smile, action. Madam. Yes, Sphinx and the pyramid. Nice picture, big smile. Rod the tani, Adil. Rod the Maharab, Adil. Yad Maharab. Ankit. Ankit. Hi, Lawrence, smile. King, the Queen. Move your hand up. Hi, King and the Queen. And sunlight too.
Aloha, I'm attorney Andre Wooten from Honolulu, and my wife Daphne and I are back in Egypt for another camel ride around the magnificent three Great Pyramid and Haramakat Sphinx complex.
When you're shooting on a pyramid, you know, long distance, it's...
Oh, that's the solar boat they found buried.
An ancient boat of the king was found buried at the foot of the Great Pyramid is in the small octagon-shaped building.
Yeah.
One of the royal boats of the king, the builder of the Grand Pyramid, was found buried at the foot of the pyramid and is over 140 feet long. It is also over 5,000 years old.
Statues of how they used to be.
The Great Pyramid of Khufu was built in the 4th dynasty around 2550 BC and has stood against the vicissitudes of time and the attacks of the Muslim, Arab, the Grand Pyramid and Haramakat Sphinx enclosure is of such sublime beauty and spiritual resonance that we just had to return and visit it one more time and thought we would like to share it with you. As awesome are the monuments of the Giza Plateau which dominate the surface and the horizon are, it is equally mind-boggling to know the extent of the subterranean tunnels, caverns, and false doors and bypasses which line the underground interior of the Giza Plateau.
This grand statue, with clearly African features, has seashells found embedded in its head, indicating that at one time it was underwater. The third largest royal pyramid.
Said that the function of the pyramid began with the early mastabas and is symbolized by the step pyramid as staircases to heaven through which the deceased king could ascend to be one and permanent and eternal with the stars. The Giza Plateau is now a suburb of modern Cairo. At 20 million people, it is reputed to be Africa's largest city. And the suburbs run right up to the enclosure of the pyramid complex.
To enter the tomb of Mary Roca, who was a governor of Kemetic. Mary Roca himself. Note the hairstyle, short dreadlocks, and of course, this is the Pallet of Narmer. While not as large as many other Egyptian artifacts, this is actually a representation of the true story of the founding of the Kemetic kingdom itself. Narmer Menes, nicknamed the Kingfish, came down the river from Abydos region and conquered the northern delta. This is a representation of Narmer striking the head of King Abascom and thus taking the kingdom of the northern delta region.
Actual statue of Pharaoh Zhoser of the third dynasty around 2700 BC, which was actually taken from the step pyramid.
We're now at the entrance of the step
pyramid. Look very carefully at his features. Look at the four lips.
The first pyramid ever built.
Of course, the nose was obliterated as a political statement. Look at his hairstyle. This is a statue of King Senwosret I, a paramount king of the 11th dynasty, who rebuilt the Grand Pyramid of Amen Ra and Waset around 2000 BC. He was said to be Sesostris, who conquered Greece. This is the trio of King Menkure, flanked by goddess Hathor and another goddess of the Delta region, carved in the black granite of Nubia of the fourth dynasty, 2500 BC. These are statues of old kingdom nobles and person the king Khufu, called Cheops by the Greeks, who was the builder of the Great Pyramid. This statue from the 4th dynasty is therefore